Yo, what's up? This is Patrick from Guy in the Queue, and I did a video about no more report builder for Power BI Paginated reports, and that's because you could design Paginated reports in the web. But this person came back and they were like, okay, but can you tell us how to do a mail merge with this? You can't. Sorry. You can't do a mail merge in the Paginated report builder just yet because you need a little more functionality. At least the functionality that I like to use. And so the first thing you need to do is go download the latest version of the Power BI Paginated report builder. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to do a mail merge. So, you know what I like to do? Enough of all this talking. Let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. After you download the Paginated report builder, what you need to do is go out to whatever source you're using. And so what I did was I'm using SQL Server. And so I created two views. One view is just a listing of all my customers. I fudged the data a little bit so I can send emails to myself, Jane, Martha, and Adam. I'm just going to spam everybody. And so this is just a listing. This is going to be used as my parameter. And then I created another view that not only contained the name and the email address, but I added some additional information because what I'm going to simulate is sending out invoices to all of my customers, but I need to do a mail merge for that. And if you're not familiar with a mail merge, if you work with Microsoft Word, you're able to kind of create a letter, not kind of, you're able to create a letter and then point to some source and merge all the address and any other information you want to use on that page. And that's what I'm going to show you how to do right here using Paginated Reports. So once all that's set up, I went over to Paginated Report Builder and I created a couple of data sets. And these data sets just point to the views. I went here, chose get data, and I connected. So if I go here and do edit mashup, you'll see here's me pointing directly to, I think I may have to connect. Yep, I'm configuring my connection. And you'll see this is just me pointing to the first view with the customer listing. You'll see a list of all the email addresses that I connected to. And then if you go here to this one, I did a little bit more with this one. This is pointing to the other view, the customer invoice view. But what I did was I followed the steps in the video I did about using the in parameter to filter out. So if you haven't seen that video, you should go take a look at that video. I followed those steps because I want to parameterize the report and choose specific customers that I do my mail merge for. All right. And so once I did that, you need to make sure that you go take a look at this doc. Avoid blank pages when printing paginated reports. And I'll put a link to this article in the description below because you want to make sure that you don't have blank pages after each grouping. I don't know how many people are printing these days, but if you're going to print, it's just a lot of blank pages that is going to print and you don't want to deal with that. All right. And so once that's done, then I need to start designing my report. So what I like to do is I like to use this list item because it gives me a free canvas to work with. I'm like a painter, right? I'm going to paint it how I want it. And so right here, here's my canvas. And then what I can do is I can go in my properties window and I can choose my data set or make sure this is selected and go to my tablets properties or I can specify my data set. So that's the first thing you want to do, right? You want to choose customer invoices and associate that data set with this list item. People may be thinking, well, Patrick, why can't we do this in Power BI? Because I'm going to do pages and pages and pages. That's what paginated reports are for. Absolutely use a paginated report. And then we start designing our report out. So I go here, I choose insert a text box. And once a text box is created, I create these placeholders. And the first one is going to be customer name. And I'm going to click my drop down, choose my customer name, click OK. Then what I'm going to do is new line, create another placeholder. This is going to be the address. And then I'm going to drop down and then you'll see the street address. And then the same thing for the city state. Another placeholder, we'll call this one city state zip. And then I don't have that in my data set. I could go back to my source and modify the view to include that, or I can do an expression right here. So I'm gonna start with the city and then I can use ampersand to do my concatenation, put a little comma there and then another ampersand. Space, make sure you put spaces between the name and the ampersand. You'll get a little error if you don't, and then postal code. Okay, and click OK. So I've created my address block. And then very important right here, go down to row groups, right click, go to group properties. We're gonna change this to customer key because that is the unique identifier for each one of my customers. Click here and choose customer key and click OK. The reason I'm doing this is because every time I encounter a new customer key, I wanna have a page break. And so if I go back to that group properties, I go to page break and I say between each instance of this group. and click OK. My parameters already set up. If you watch the other video, if I go to data set properties, you'll remember that I set my parameter up this way. Gotta go check that video out. I'm not gonna go into details about that here. If I run my report, you see report parameter one, I probably should change that. If I choose a couple of names here and I click view report, you should see four pages. There's Jane, there's Patrick, there's Adam, and there's Martha. And now I wanna add the details of my invoice here. So I'm gonna go to insert, I'm gonna choose table, I'm gonna insert a table, drop it down right there. And then what I'm gonna do, because that data set's associated to it, I automatically have access to all those columns. I'm gonna choose product name, I'm gonna choose sales amount, I'm gonna choose tax, I'm gonna insert a column to the right, I'm gonna choose freight, and then I'm gonna insert another column to the right, and we'll call this, you know, subtotal. And then I'll go here and do an expression. And then all I'm gonna do is go here and add some stuff up. Sales amount plus freight plus tax. It's really simple. Click OK. And now if I run this, take a look at my report. It won't be perfectly formatted, but you can see, right? It's all my stuff here. If I go to another page, this is all Patrick's products, Adam's products, Adam didn't purchase as much, and then Martha's product. And so like a cooking show, here's a report that I finished. So you could, I did some formatting, I added a line, added a date, added a little salutation, a little greeting, and a phone number. And if I run this report, here we go. So select the emails, choose a couple of emails, view this report. I'm not the best report designer, as Martha points out in a few of her videos already, but you can see, right? Here's the one for Jane. Looks okay. I can print this out. I can fold this up, put this in an envelope. It's pretty easy to do. So that's the merging and the creating of a report. But how do I get it out? Let me show you. So once I'm done designing this, I'll publish this up to the service, which I've already done. Let me head over to the service and I can select the parameters just like I did before. View the report. Here's my report directly in a web browser. I can export this. But what I've done is, because we're doing a mail merge, you want to send these out. I click subscribe and I created two subscriptions. So one subscription is just going to drop this down to a OneDrive. And so if you go to my subscription, you'll see it's a PDF down the SharePoint. And then here's another one that's actually a dynamic subscription that's going to email this out based on that customer listing data set. And it's going to send it to the email addresses in that data set. Be careful when you're doing this, because if you have too many email addresses, you're gonna blast this out. So you need to think about this. And once you execute either one of these subscriptions, so if I go out to my OneDrive, I've executed this subscription and it's only for the four people, the four filters that I set up. And it's a single page for each one. And it just saved this out on my OneDrive. And then if we go over to Jane Doe's, so you can see she gets an email. Let's download this and open this up. And what you'll see is she gets a single page for her invoice. Just like that, I've created a mail merge. Few steps, but I'll make sure you get a copy of that RDL and maybe even a copy of this PDF so you can see what it looks like. It'll be in the description below. All right, keep the questions coming. If you have questions about this, about what I did, post it in the comments below. I know it's a little old school, but it was fun. I decided to take a break from all the super techie stuff and just do something really simple that put a smile on my face. All right, what do you think? Yeah, questions, comments, you know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If you want to learn more about Fabric or Power BI, all the workloads in Fabric, probably a video flying above my head. And as always, from Adam, Martha, and this guy, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.